Ah, trees. What would the world be like without them? Here in Dillydale, they are a source of wonder. They offer hours of climbing enjoyment. They provide homes for birds. And sometimes, they even break a fall. If it weren't for trees, Mr. Quiet wouldn't be able to build a treehouse and enjoy a place to get away from it all. Or get away from a chatty neighbor.
Hello there, Mr. Quiet. I see you've built a treehouse. I have always wanted my very own treehouse. Not sure why. Of course, I've also wanted a house made of marshmallows. What made you build a treehouse, anyway?
Oh, you know, to have a place to think alone.
Miss Helpful's dog grooming business, where we shear head to rear. Miss Helpful, you have to see this. Mr. Quiet built the most awesome treehouse. Oh, hey there, Miss Chatterbox. Can't talk now. I'm kind of in the middle of shearing Miss Sunshine's poodle. Good enough. Be right there. Mr. Quiet, are you sure this ladder is safe? Seems a little shaky.
It's very dangerous. Why would you climb up here if I were you?
Howdy, Miss Chatterbox. I brought a few things to help Mr. Quiet brighten up the place. Wow, what a good idea. I didn't bring anything, not even crackers.
Now that's what I call a treehouse.
Hi, Mr. Noisy. Isn't it great?
Great? It's super!
Go away. Nothing to see here. Moving on.
Mind if we come up and take a look?
Oh.
I brought you some housewarming gifts. Huh. Now that I'm in an actual treehouse, I don't think I like it that much. It's too leafy. Yep, I'd rather have a marshmallow house. No leaves, just lots and lots of marshmallows. Some figurines will make it a lot nicer.
Let's see how the sound is up here. Mr. Quiet's got a treehouse, say yeah!
Yeah!
Mr. Quiet's got a treehouse, say yeah, yeah!
Yeah, yeah!
Yep, it sounds great up here. It's super!
Still need some sprucing up. Phew, this is heavy.
No, don't set it down. Too heavy.
Wow, the ground's a really bad place for a ladder when you're up in a treehouse. I don't suppose you have any parachutes up here? Oh, well, might as well make the best of it till someone finds us.
That's the spirit! If you're stuck in Quiet's treehouse, say yeah!
Yeah!
If you're stuck in Quiet's treehouse, say yeah, yeah!
Yeah, yeah!
Magic's amazing tree wand. Just wave my wand over your tree and it will grow to twice the size.
It's like magic.
Oh, it's not like magic. It is magic. My amazing magic tree wand works on any tree, like a sick oak tree. Give it a try, Mr. Nervous. My amazing tree wand has transformed trees all over Dillydale. My amazing tree wand even works on miniature trees to give them that something extra.
Oh! Sweet Henrietta! Put me down!
Sometimes my magic surprises even me. Don't delay and order your very own amazing tree wand today!
There are some trees which are so large, you can drive right through them. Providing you follow the rules, of course.
Hello, Mr. Happy. How much does it cost to drive through the tree tunnel?
Oh, admission is free, Miss Sunshine. I'm just here to answer any questions.
Why would anyone carve a tunnel through a tree when they could just drive around it?
Because, Miss Curious, it's wonderful!
Ouchie!
That's a wonderfully giant pine cone!
Cut the chit-chat. I do not have all day.
Oh, go ahead of me, Mr. Rude. I have to put my top up in case one of those giant pine cones falls on me.
I'm sorry, Mr. Rude, but your car is much too big to go through the tree tunnel.
I do not care. I am going anyway.
I really don't think you should do that, or else you might get...
I'm stuck.
You bet you're stuck!
I came as soon as I heard. Who needs the tickle?
Get me out of here!
I bet Mr. Rude would like a tickle right about now.
Yes, don't just stand there, you nincompoops. Do something.
I don't think I can reach him in there. But since I'm here, would anyone else like a tickle?
What's going on up there?
Mr. Rude's stuck in the tree.
Oh, figures he'd pull a stunt like this on the best trout fishing day of the year.
Why did you drive into that tree after Mr. Happy said you wouldn't fit?
Will somebody take her away? Preferably a bear.
Everyone, I've just written a song called The Sad Tale of Brave Mr. Rude. He was just like you and me. Now he's stuck inside a tree.
Well, that's an awful pretty song, Miss Sunshine. Kind of sad, though.
It certainly is, Mr. Strong, and it's based on a true story.
No kidding. Yo, Mr. Rude, I'm gonna try to push the car through, okay?
I don't care what you do. Just get me out of here!
Everyone, I just thought of a new song. The Sad Tale of Brave Mr. Strong. He is just like a hus, yet he can move above a hus.
I have had enough of your song. Finally, I can get away from these chuckleheads. Go!
Now Mr. Rude is over there, making friends with the grizzly bear.
Over in the Dillydale rainforest, Mr. Bump and Miss Scary are in search of a most unusual creature that lives high up in the treetops.
Thanks for offering to be my camera person on this assignment, Miss Scary.
Are you kidding? Troop through a rainforest crawling with creepy critters? There's nothing better. What are we searching for anyway?
That would be the rare tiny orange speckled tree frog.
Speckled tree frog? That's not scary.
Yeah, well, that's the assignment.
You think there are any snakes around here?
Oh, well, no need to find out. Let's keep focused on the tiny and harmless speckled tree frog, wherever it may be.
I know. Why don't I scare it out?
Not a good idea. Wouldn't want to scare out any snakes. According to my map, the tiny orange speckled tree frog makes its home up in those trees. A pulley system will slowly raise us into the treetops.
Like this!
Okay, nothing to it. Your turn. Nope. You don't appear to be the tiny orange speckled tree frog. You neither.
Gotcha!
You certainly did. Let me show you how we carefully slide onto the zip line.
Look! Snake! Just kidding!
That's not what I meant to do! that frog doesn't sound very tiny.
Oh, you got that right. See ya.
Oh, oh, cold frog tongue.
There's no doubt about it. Dreams play an important part in the lives of the Mr. Men and Little Misses. So do take the time to notice the trees in your neighborhood. Though they are perhaps best viewed from the ground.